on, Lee. Let's bring you
Come
in
on, man. We want to hear some of
here.
Your some of Lee Goldberg. Right, he's got
All right. So listen,
talk about
my
a guitar
name's
player.
Not Goldberg. That can play. My name's not Goldenberg. It's Goldberg. Please,
I'm sorry,
please,
Goldberg.
Please.
It's he, but he plays like gold and sings just as good as silver. I'm telling you
That's
right now.
That's my volume. Yeah, I took the third reboot, and then I finally put the. Put the APH on here, right? The anointed postal hat, and just prayed, and everything sort of worked out.
So he's got the anointed postal hat. I passed those out a couple years ago to all the people in my the group that I was involved with, the inner circle, and I prayed of all these hats, and I always told people that whenever they wear the postal hat, it's anointed. It has a double anointing on it. And look, he's got the Heavenbound song.
I got the Heavenbound hat.
He's got the Liz Collins hat.
When we were playing with Eddie. So if I had two heads, I. Okay. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay. All right,
yep.
Good. Okay. So, oh my gosh, I got so much I want to do tonight, but you looked tired before you got started. I wasn't sure if we were going to get more than a couple of tunes in before you fell asleep.
We're wide awake now.
Okay. Well, here we go. Let's start with, you know what? If I'm going to do a James Taylor, I got to do it, get out of the way, and move into the anointing. Otherwise, I got to not do it, you know? So, let me go ahead and do a little JT. I do also a lot from the other JT, Jethro Tull.
I never thought of JT being Jethro Tull as well. Yeah, the initials. Forgot about
that. Well, I played a lot of both. not so much anymore. I pretty much stick to the Christian stuff. You kind of pulled this out. Like whether God's happy or sad, I don't know. Find out. How's the volume on that?
You can put it up, bring it up a little bit. Bring it up a little bit.
Okay, bring it up a little. All right, let's try that there.
The highway, won't you lend me your name? The way and my way seem to be one and the same. Mama don't understand it, wants to know where I've been. Had to be some kind of natural bum fool to want to pass that way again. But you know I can feel it. On a country road, known to Jesus, won't you good girls and boys? I'm all in pieces, but you can have your own choice. I got me a heavenly band full of angels, and they're coming to set me free. I don't know nothing about the wild wind, but I can tell you that it's bound to be. And don't you know I can feel it, child, yeah. On a country road, guess my feet know where they want me to go. Walking on a country road. Hey, to the highway, won't you lend me your name? Your way and my way seem to be one and the same. Mama don't understand it, she wants to know where I've been. Had to be some kind of natural born fool to want to pass that way again. But I can feel it on a country road. Walk on down, walk on down, walk on down, walk on down, walk on down that country. she rolls. La 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 country road, a country road. I guess my feet know where they want me to go. Walk on down the country road. Yeah.
That was smoothly. Very well played. A great old tune from the past.
So,
James Taylor.
My wife just brought this. She found it.
Show me.
I showed you. I showed you.
Look at that crazy blessed.
She found this at Hobby Lobby when she went there. She goes there. We have an Etsy business. She does some stuff. She has to go there a fair amount. And so she saw this and she's like, "Yeah, look what I found." You know.
That's awesome. Yeah, I'm so Coley would like to see that. I forgot to mention that to her.
Okay. So anyway, so let's do, you know my story. I've been doing all these scriptures. I stopped after a year. I tried to write some regular long songs and they just weren't coming. So I'm doing the scriptures again and they came fine. So I did, since July 1st, I've started a bunch of new ones. They're all on YouTube. The old ones I'm putting on Facebook.
So yeah, Lee does scripture verses. They may be only 20 seconds long.
I gotta remember to tune up from the drop D. This is Ephesians 1:3.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
Short and sweet. Short and sweet.
They are short. You know what? If you don't like one, there's another one coming around the corner. It's going to sound different. You may like that one instead.
It hits you right in the face.
I have to thank Steve Howe for that. There's from the lead guitarist from Yes. That's a great chord, chording that he has. I liked it, so I stole it. I guess he doesn't own the chord, you know. Anyway.
Yeah, fortunately, otherwise we all be in trouble.
That's true. If I could just like own the G chord, that would be good. If I could get royalties every time somebody played just the G chord, just not another one. All right, so Psalm 46:10, this is probably one of my favorite ones.
Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I'll be exalted in the earth.
Forgot to turn the volume back up after the banging with the pick. Sorry about that. Anyway,
you can still hear it fine. Yeah, your audio is really good right now. You can really hear you very well.
Okay, that's good. Well, I'm telling you, it was good. I was just like, all right, everything's cool. You know, I'm like a guy that would like initially, I would just be all tied up in little knots and stuff. And I'm like, you know, whatever it is, you know, Lord, there's a little test here for me, right?
Definitely a test, but everything's fine now.
So anyway, this next song, I'm going to be doing songs I don't do that often. So this next song, I'm going to be 64 next month. And when I was 60, I'm looking in the mirror and I'm going, wow, how did I get this old? You know, I was washing my hands. I'm like, wow, how did I get this old? You know, because the days are long, man, but life is short. And I went, that sounds like a song. So I wrote a song called The Days Are Long and the Life is Short, and ended up sort of being a bit of a, possibly an evangelistic sort of thing, right? You can earn more money, but you can never earn more time. Chasing after all those things you think are so sublime. You climb the corporate ladder just to earn another dime, while your family and creator are at the back of the line. The days are long, but the life is short. This is the truth that I must put forth. The days are long, but the life is short. So be wise with your days. You can drive a sports car or take your limousine instead. And if you die with the most toys, well, you still in fact are dead. Try to gain the whole world, but lose your soul instead. You sacrifice what matters for a crumbling crust of bread. The days are long, but the life is short. This is the truth that I must put forth. The days are long, but the life is short. So be wise with your years. You can change your ways, look forward to the better days, hold on to what will last. The future's not determined by your past. The days are long, but the life is short. This is the truth that I must put forth. The days are long, but the life is short. So be wise with your days. The days are long, but the life is short. This is the truth that I must report. The days are long, but the life is short. So be wise with your days. And be wise with your years. You gotta be wise with your life.
So true. I mean, when you're younger, you know, when you're younger growing up as a teenager, you know, and stuff, oh, I can't wait till I'm 21. Man, it takes forever to get there. It seems like it's a lifetime to get to 21. Oh, man, I just need to get there. And then all of a sudden, you get there, and then all of a sudden, uh-oh, life speeds up. All of a sudden, you're like, you're getting older, man. Man, time is flying. And all of a sudden, you don't realize where all the time go. Life is so short, isn't it? It really is.
Right. But I got days that seem like they're never going to end, you know?
Some days. And that's the weird part. Some days like that, you know?
Yeah. You know? So, anyway, so that's that one there. It sort of turned out to be a bit of a, you know, evangelism. My brother loves the line that if you die with the most toys, well, you still, in fact, are dead. You know, because they used to say, he who dies with the most toys wins, right? And that's like, wrong answer, you know. Anyway, so this next song, when I first got saved, it was 1986. And the church that I ended up going to, they had bought this property to build another church on, the new big church on. And it had like, it was like this little, I don't know, a place where you'd like, there was like a chapel, and there's all these little buildings and stuff, like somebody used to pay to go and see all this stuff. So until they built the building, they were having the men's prayer meeting in this little tiny chapel on this property. And so I used to go, I like jump all in. I got saved and I'm like, boom, I'm in, you know, I'm doing everything. And so somebody was praying and they're like, oh, God, just if we could just touch your throne, oh God. And I'm like, ding, 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 ding. There's a song. Okay. So so I wrote the song. Actually, the guy who ran the prayer meeting, his name is Bill Warner. This is his favorite song. He loves the song. This is very different than most of the stuff I do. It's a worship song. Touch the throne of God. You are mighty and you are worthy. You are worthy of all praise. You are worthy. Oh, to touch the throne of God. Oh, to touch the throne of God. To Him all glory, to Him all majesty, to Him all honor for all time. Him all honor for all time. He will never leave you. Hello? He will not forsake you. He will never ever let you go. He will always love you. Always reign above you. Blessing all with peace and joy, love, joy and love. Touch the throne of God. Oh, to touch the throne of God. Him will glorify, it's Him will magnify, and all we do within His name. Rejoice to know He'll never change. Oh, to touch the throne. Oh, to touch the throne of God. Oh, to touch the throne of God.
A worship song from Lee Goldberg.
Some people, thank you. Yeah, some people don't have their mic off, I guess. I'm hearing all kind of other noises. And I guess that was...
I heard too. Yeah, sometimes it happens. Sometimes, you know, for you're not muted, some sounds come from up in the peanut gallery up there. But you kept going and didn't let it distract you. So it just kept going.
I got to get my granddaughter to come on here. But, you know, she first time she played, she always sang with the worship team. The first time she played with the ukulele and accompanied herself, the mic... The screw wasn't in there, right? And she's in front of the whole school, and the mic's going like this, you know, and somebody runs over, and they picked it up, but they're not thinking, I better take this. Keeps going down, and she's like, she handled it so very well. I was very proud of her.
I think you shared that clip with me. I remember you saying that.
Oh, yeah, she's really, really good. You know, I was like, my wife's like, what? I'm like, oh, she's awesome. She's like, really? You're just so picky. What do you mean she's awesome? I said, she's awesome. She's really good. Anyway, so yeah. So she's like, the mic kept going down. I felt really bad for her. First time she was not just singing with the worship team, you know. Okay, so there's a song I wrote a number of years ago, in fact, and it was probably one of the hardest songs I've ever had to write. And I mean, I had my class at school praying for me about through it and all, and it's I asked Rick to listen to it because I wanted to make sure it was going to be
okay. You got to hear this song. This song, I mean, I tell you what, he asked if we could sing it or not, and I said, man, you got to go with it. I am totally with this song. It's listen to the words. The words are just
what it
powerful.
Is
the lyrics
a song
are great.
That, you know, if you guys,
and it's about a certain topic that we all know. It's,
that we all know, right? So
we know.
So back, right. So back in the Old Testament, there was a god named Moloch, and they used to. It was like this whole fiery thing with all these different chambers, and you know, you could give all kind of different offerings, but the ultimate offering was to put your child in there, pass them through the fire to Moloch. And I determined, not alone, many people have thought this, that same spirit is alive today with the abortion industry. And so the name of this song, it's called The Forceps is the Fire. First time I've played it live. Face of a calf beckons with outstretched arms, heated hot with fire, yet no one was alarmed at the screams of the innocent, barely drowned by beating drums as they passed them through the fire till they one by one succumbed. Forceps is the fire, they pass their children through. The forceps is the fire, the sacrifice is due. Tainted tools of stainless steel, the priests approach their prey. The forceps is the fire, it's on display today. Seven chapel chambers, heated until they glow. Would it be a dove, a ram, an ox, or human blood that flowed? Each one showed commitment of just how far they'd go to appease that one called Moloch with the gifts they would bestow. Forceps is the fire, they pass their children through. The forceps is the fire, the sacrifice is due. The tainted tools of stainless steel, the priests approach their prey. The forceps is the fire, it's on display today. Forceps is the fire, they pass their children through. The forceps is the fire, a sacrifice is due. A medical procedure, it's a woman's right to choose. But what about that baby who has everything to lose? On the altar of convenience,
child pays for parents' sin. The forceps is the fire, let the sacrifice begin.
That last song at the end, man. Oh my God. That is a powerful song. Isn't that a powerful song, guys? That is a powerful song. I said he had to play
that. It just came out of me when I was playing it live. I had no intention nor knew I was going to. That was flat out the Holy Spirit that did that. And when I heard it, man, it just gave me the.
That is so effective. As a song for today, brother, that song has to be out there. I'm telling you, that should be played everywhere. That is powerful.
Yeah, well, okay, and they're gonna have stones, you know.
Well, anyway. Yeah. Right. I'm sure you can handle the stones, though.
Not the rolling stones. We're talking about big, nasty stones that they're trying to kill you with, right? Anyway.
Yeah, but it's worth it. It'd be worth getting stoned for that.
Well,
song.
Well, I know I had to write the song. It was very hard, and I had lots of people praying for me. It came out, and I'm like, "Great, Lord, but this thing's intense. How am I ever gonna play this anywhere? Anyway,
you can play it here anytime you want.
Okay, there you go. Bring the room down. You know. All right, so it's kind of interesting. I wrote a song called "Be Strong and of Good Courage," and that's what the Lord told Joshua 1:9 when he was taking the Israelites over. And there was a time I took a class at church, and I was doing, I don't know if anybody's ever heard of prophetic art, and I was doing prophetic art. And I was like wondering, you know, how much God was really involved in it. And it was very intense that he was very involved in it. But I did a piece here, okay? It says, "Be strong and of good courage in the shape of a sword," okay? In Joshua 1:9. And what you see in the back is not an elephant, as most people think they are, but it's a rabbi blowing a gigantic shofar, ram's horn. Okay, which is the battle cry before you go into battle. So I also wrote this song, and it's called, funnily enough, "Be Strong and of Good Courage."
Lee is. You see, I've seen some of his artwork. Oh my gosh, that guy can. He is quite the artist, bro. Well, you people should know that he is. If you want some artwork done, art's the guy. He's the guy.
Halt you from the crowd, just take your stand, speak sure and proud. This must be war. Called you soldier, my warrior, don't be afraid. Just march on with the plans I've made. Die to yourself, lay your desires upon the shelf. And be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage and do it for me. For me, for me. Take the straight and narrow way, obey and follow me day by day. Fulfill my call, dispel the darkness, tear down the walls. You are my hands upon the earth here to conquer lands for Christ the Lord. Now gird yourself and draw your sword. Be strong and of good courage. Strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage and do it for me. For me, for me. by step, success will overtake you. Prosper you whichever way you turn. Meditate upon my word and know it is a two-edged sword. Be careful now to live the lessons learned. Be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage and do it for me. For me, for me. Be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage. Be strong and of good courage and do it for me. For me, for me.
Be strong and of good courage and do it for me. Those are powerful words there, Lee.
You know, there's like Woo-hoo! Three types of songs. There's songs from God, like him talking, songs to God, you talking, and songs about God. So, anyway, all right. Maybe we should do a scripture here. Oh, here's a cool one. I'm not in tune, I can't keep going, sorry.
I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep.
Another short and sweet one.
I was trying to do a few of these that I...
So how many of those scripture verse songs do you have? I think you told me you have like a year's worth.
There's over 400 now. I did I did 365 and stopped, took 4 months, could not write a song and said, okay, am I supposed to go back and do those other things? And I did. And they started coming. And so starting July 1st on YouTube, every day, one of these is coming out. And... So what was that, about another 6 weeks worth? So there's over 400 now, because there was 365 when I stopped in February after the first year. I'm looking to go for 6 months. I was so July 1st to the end of December, I figure. That'll be another 180 on top of the 365. So it'll be over 500 probably.
And so where can we find these songs? Can we find them on YouTube?
Lee Goldberg Music on YouTube. Yeah, you can find
there you
everything
go. If you wanna...
there, you know. Everything is there and you can listen to all of it until you're sick of hearing me.
We have several sermons worth of scripture verses and psalms on YouTube with Lee Goldberg. Go to his channel. You'll hear a message in scripture in his songs. There you go.
Ta-da. All right, so let me, maybe I should go back to the little... finger picking. This is a song I wrote many, many years ago. It's a song about contrasts, actually. It's one of my one and only studio projects called Mostly His Love.
His hands are strong and mighty to calm the angry sea. His hands are soft and gentle for holding you and me. His ways will lead to glory and things you've not thought of. God has many things to offer, but mostly He is love. God has many things to offer, but mostly He is love. He creates the mighty oceans and the tallest of the trees. He creates the drops of dew upon a petal in the breeze. He is great and holy, reigning on his throne above. God has many things to all, but mostly he is love. God is many things to all, but mostly he is love. Punishment is death, yet to all he offers life, so easy and so glorious, through our Lord Jesus Christ. God of all the universe created earth and sun, yet in his love it seems as though you are the only one. The Lord is full of power, his breath creates the lands. Yet humble to the point of death, through piercing of his hands. And his plans for you are perfect, they'll fit you like a glove. God has many things to all, but mostly he is love. God is many things to all, but mostly he is love. God is many things to all, but mostly he is love.
That was a sweet one, man. That was sweet. That was gentle. That was definitely a gentle one. That was awesome.
That was.
I like the way you played it. Everybody loves it. Everybody loves it. Just ministered. That was a ministry song right there.
Yeah. Cool. All right. There. Good. Yeah. It's, you know, I got a lot of songs. Some of them. It's funny because some of the ones I don't think are maybe that good, other people really like a lot, and vice versa. So, you know, of course, my opinion counts because I'm playing them. So you know what I mean. but it's always interesting to. To hear.
Well, it just felt like love. You know, the song was about love.
It felt like love.
It's like kick gloves. It was just like this. Yeah, I felt like love was just handed to us. Just like
okay.
That.
Anyway, so do any of you, I'm going to do a cover now. Is any of you familiar with the band called Iona? They're like a Celtic Christian band. They do like stuff for like, very interesting, really, really nice stuff. Well, anyway, so this is a song called Chiro, and I don't know if you're ever familiar with Chiro. You see it a lot, I guess, in the Catholic Church. It's two Greek letters, right? Chiro, and it's a Christogram, and it's one of the older Celtic, you know, like the fish, you know, means Christ, and so there's the chi and the ro. It's nobody's getting it, but anyway, so the song's called Chiro. It's about Jesus.
We believe you, Lee. We believe you.
I wish I had my, I used to have one on my other guitar. Color of green, green for the vine, for the leaves and the branches, the tree of life. Color of red for the wound that are deeper than I can know. How deep the flow. By him all things were created, Giro. This is where the whole band comes in now, but they didn't show up tonight. Color of gold, gold for a throne, for the light that is blazing around his face. Color of white, pure, poor purity, white as snow, the colors flow. The mystery of Giro. By him all things were created. By him all things were created. And the fullness of the Godhead is in.
Says she likes the way you play the guitar now, and that was sweet. Very nice.
It's written by the lead.
So let me ask you this now. You're a songwriter, and you write a lot of songs. You have to spend a lot of time getting songs the way you get songs. I mean, obviously, it doesn't just come overnight. Yes. All of a sudden, you wake up and the songs come to you. You must spend a lot of time before the Lord playing that guitar and writing, right? Am I right?
That's true. And back in the day, before the internet was there, I had a rhyming dictionary, which if you've ever used one, they're the most frustrating things on the planet to try and use. A rhyming dictionary, a thesaurus, and all this, you know. And before I used that, I would just like, okay, I would like go through the alphabet, A, B, C, D, E, and like, okay, what rhymed with the word I just used? Yeah, okay, well, I found a good rhyme. I didn't find a good rhyme. Okay, then let's change the word. And so, yeah, it's definitely a lot of massaging, you know. I heard somebody say one time, good songs are not written, they are rewritten. Another guy said, you write for the trash can, and occasionally one's okay, and you play it. So, and this guy was a full-time songwriter.
Good point. Yes, songs can change over time.
Yeah, so I've gotten some. I mean, I have some crazy like rhymes and near rhymes and stuff like shattered self righteousness now will enlighten us. You know, it's like it's like okay, so.
Yeah, so you have and most people just rhyme C and B and like just easy words, simple syllable words, but you come up with these like, you know, four syllable words to rhyme. I mean, that's creative.
And I'm a fan of the near rhyme too, which works real well. You know, if the cadence is good and the rhyme is close, sometimes I like them actually even better. But yeah, I mean, everybody, you know, is like, you know, frog and dog. I mean, you know, anybody can come up with those ones, but you know, I work, I don't know, it's just, it's the way I, it's just the way I am. It's the way I was put together, I guess, you know? And also, I don't do these, like, Throne of God songs. They're very rare, few and far between. It's more like the forceps is the fire and you know.
Well, you have your own style, and that's you. That's who you are. And you're definitely unique, and it sets you apart, I think. You know, like Liz has her style, and it sets her apart. You have your style.
I would get hurt trying to do what Liz does, I think, physically. I would get hurt.
I think everybody would. Yes, get me.
At first, Liz, I have to be honest. The first time I ever heard Liz, because I didn't know who she was when I knew that I heard that we were going to be with Eddie, right? And so I was like, well, let me see if I can find what she's doing. And I'm listening to her, and I'm going, you know, she's trying too hard. And then I listened to a little more, and I went, no, that's just who she is, you know? So it was like, but I was like, this is really cool. I mean, this is like, it's at a different level of like just gut, you know? My stuff is a little more cerebral, and sometimes people miss it, you know? But you can't miss the stuff that hits you right in the gut, you know? And so.
That's a great way of describing it. I like the way you describe the difference between you and her. Yeah, I agree. Hers is all good.
So, but we had a great time. We had a great time with that. You're going to be back, right? You're going to go back, right? Liz, you're going back this year, right?
Where? To
Wildwood, Eddie.
No, you know, like I'm just because of my, you know, my issues at the moment, my health issues,
okay.
I'm just not driving like really far from home yet, you know, kind of just been staying close, still trying to do some healing. And those steps are torture going up and going up.
You're
to
telling
the,
me I didn't have my hip replaced yet when I, you remember I had a cane. I was like, I couldn't, it was a mess.
And if I were there like now, you know, it's like I'd have to ask everybody to carry everything for me. Cause I just, it just would just be crazy.
That's what I did
so anyway,
last year.
So anyway, are you? So you're going? You're gonna go?
Yeah, I'm going.
All right, I'm gonna be.
Art Savanya is gonna be there. He fell and hurt himself, so he doesn't even know if he's gonna be able to play.
Oh no! What is happening? What is happening to us?
You guys are getting old. Hey, listen, Lee shared with me a picture of Eddie, Liz, and Lee himself playing together on stage.
Oh,
well, that was last year.
Susan was taking all the pictures, was taking lots of pictures of us. This is Eddie's wife. Real nice lady. It was great.
I'll be praying for you all, okay? And hopefully next year, I hope next year will be just, you know, better year. Yeah. It's gotta be. It's just gotta be better than this year.
There you go. And then,
if it's worse than this year, I'm gonna just say, Jesus, beam me up, okay? Just beam me up.
So, yeah, okay. And then Wednesday, I'm actually playing live in Ocean Grove, New Jersey. It's right south of Asbury Park, and a lot of hymns were written there, like people that went there for the summer, like some real famous hymns have been written there. And it's sort of like this whole Christian town. And it also happens to be the town, as an architect I appreciate, it's with the most Victorian architecture of any town in the country.
Nice.
And I thought Cape May, which is down south here in Jersey, was the one, but no. So I'll be up there. They have a pavilion and they do music three times a day the whole summer. So that'll be cool. This is fun, but it's like when you're done playing the song, it's kind of like, like there's no response or anything, you know, and it's like I don't know what to do, you know. Anyway, so what do I have a little time or what?
But you can play one more if you want to play, maybe two.
All right. Well, if it's two, because I want to end with the one that I sent you the lyrics on.
Yeah.
To that one I want to end on. So if I can do two, I'm gonna do one other one first, and then I'll do that one.
Okay.
All right. Maybe I'll just do a couple scriptures then maybe that I haven't even. Even before. Two or three have gathered together in my name, I am there. Two or three have gathered together in my name, I am there in their midst. Matthew 18:20.
Nice.
Do you see a man wise in his own eyes?
more for a fool than for him. There's more for a fool than for him.
Proverbs 26:12. I don't have these memorized. You know, it's like I have the songs memorized, but I don't know what the verses are, right? And this one, I was asked to make a whole song out of it by a friend of mine, but so we'll see. We'll see what happens, you know.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and will dine with him and he with me.
Short and sweet.
They are. Like I said, if you don't like it, there's another one coming. You might like that one. If it convicted you, maybe the next one will be a little gentler. I don't know, you know. Anyway, so Liz has probably heard that. Most of you have probably heard this song. I've been playing it since 1991 when I wrote it. It's called Toxic Wasted Blues. I actually wrote it for a play on America, a show that my church was doing, and when I played it for him, they said, no, you're not playing that. I'm not letting you play. Okay, so when I introduce it, it's my socioeconomic, religious, environmental, politically incorrect, tongue-in-cheek song that's been banned in certain parts of the country. So now I played that. I said that to Red the other day, texted it to him, and he's like, oh, well, you know, I don't know. I don't want us to get shut down or anything. Like he didn't understand that it was a joke, you know. So this is, it's all about basically, hey, God is sovereign even with all the crazy stuff happening. I have to remember, this was written in 1991. I had to adjust some lyrics because people aren't talking about acid rain anymore, you know, things like that. And then after COVID, I wrote another verse. And you may have heard that one, okay? I'm just minding my own business not that long ago, last couple weeks ago. And then I had to write one about Donald Trump getting shot. So that's the verse now that I did play it once on Reds, but it will be new to you guys tonight. And so anyway, it's my socioeconomic, religious, environmental, politically incorrect, tongue-in-cheek songs and banned in certain parts of the country. All of that is true. Okay. It's called Toxic Wasted Blues. And just not, listen to the words, you know, right?
It's not banded here. It's not banded here, folks.
It's a lot of words.
God is always faithful in everything he said. Even though the climate change is messing with your head, he'll straighten out your life if you stay within his will. He's even sovereign over every single oil spill. So don't worry about your country, don't you fret about your land. It's like the United States, environmentally toxic, wasted blues in his hands. He'll give you life abundantly and on that you can bet. He knows so many trillions that our country is in debt. So just lean your life upon him, you surely will prevail. He's the one who gives that dying breath to every slaughtered whale. So don't worry about your country, don't fret about your land. He's got the United States, environmentally toxic, wasted blues in his hands. All right, now let's hear the sing-along part, ready? He watches them raise the utility bills and he knows of the contents of all the landfills. He's aware that the ozone is leaving and he's created the half-life of nuclear waste. So he's totally sovereign in every way and surely this country does need him today. Nobody was singing. Well, he sees you when you prosper and he sees you when you laugh. He knows the name of everyone who died today on crack. He loves the one who's upright, one who's rotten to the core. And he's not concerned at all about the threats of nuclear war. So So live your life with trust in him. You know you cannot lose, and know that he's one step ahead of all that daily news. And don't you worry about your country, don't fret about your land. He's not the United States. Environmentally toxic, wasted blues in his hand. Well, I had to write another verse about COVID, and it goes something like this. You might see you take the vaccine, he might see you say not me. He knows that masks are just to see how compliant you will be to the ones who have the power to say what's right and what is wrong. And who has the power is the only thing that this has been about all along. So live your life with trust in him. There is no other way to get out from under the evil you see is all around today. So don't you worry about your country, don't fret about your land. The United States, environmentally toxic, Marxist blues in his hand. I thought I was done, and then Trump got shot, and I just had to write another verse, and it goes like this. You see, they took a shot at Donald Trump during his speech. If God didn't turn his head, his life would now be out of reach. He's the one who has the power over life or death, you see. And what the devil meant for evil, God used for the greater victory. So trust in him at all times, for it is the better path than trusting in yourself. Come on now, just do the math. Don't you worry about your country, don't you fret about your land. The United States, environmentally, notoriously, politically, unequivocally, significantly, assassination, attemptedly, blues in his hand. Oh yeah, and you ain't going yet if it ain't your time.
That's an outstanding song. I hope everybody out there like on Facebook. That was outstanding. Loved it. Loved the Trump verse and all the other verses, all the other lines.
Yeah,
and
that was, those lines are so quick. Work in progress as long
those,
as
I'm yeah, going. I know. We might, but that song may end up being like 10 minutes long.
There's like there's like 10,000 words in it, and it's like 3 minutes long. You know,
and they say them so fast. Like you're faster than a rapper sings his or his song. By that song, that was really fast. To remember all those words that fast.
I wrote this in 1991. That was before that. I think they were doing rap. That was a long time before rap, I think.
So that song has lasted like 30 years now, more than 30 years.
Right. I changed Acid Rain to Climate Change, and a couple other things too. Yes. Yeah, nobody was talking, you know, like Acid Rain, well, that's not a thing anymore. You know, now we're talking about climate change. Because that way, whether the weather's cold or hot, then we can still complain and say that we're all going to die, you know.
So. Definitely keeping up with the times. It changes all the time.
My wife.
Times, they are changing.
She listens. I do spreadsheets during the day, so I can't really listen to anything that's distracting. But she does all our Etsy business, and she listens to all that stuff, man. And she knows everything, and she tells it all to me. So.
Wow.
That's where I get my news
Very
from.
Cool. Very cool.
My wife. So.
Well, Brother Lee, all I got to say is that's right up my gutsy aisle there, brother.
Yeah, if I disappear, it's because I played that song somewhere.
And I disappear. You disappear only because you got raptured. That's all I would say, anyway.
I hope so, yeah.
Yeah.
So it could be any day.
That
now,
was great. That was great. I love the song.
Rick, should we, Rick, should we bring in our artist to say goodnight?
You can say that if it